Hello guys, welcome back once again to our YouTube channel Unique Civil Minds. I hope you are doing great. In today's lecture we are going to learn about chamfer. In this chamfer we got the two different methods, like we got in the same only one method in case of your fillet, but here we got the two different methods, that is your distance method and angle method. So under this two different methods we got the similar two process we are going to follow over here, that is your multiple method, polyline method, trim or no trim method. So first we'll go with respect to your distance method. So under this distance method, see here I have been taken for example in as a case of your rectangle. So here we got the chamfer command key, that is called CHA, press enter. Later on what it is going to indicate, or it is showing you at the bottom. So here we are going to get the some following processes out of this, which you required, you need to select that one. So first I was selecting as a distance method. So first I was dealing with the distance, so I will take as a D. I was giving a command D and press enter. Now it is asking you specify first chamfer distance. If I was considering this is my first line, or first I need to be chamfered for this line, so again from this point how much distance or at what distance I need to chamfered for this line. So I was taking around 4 inch, whereas I was giving the 4 inch for this line. If I was considering this as second, or you can consider this as second, right? So if I was considering this as second, so again it is asking from this point at how what distance I need to be chamfered. So you need to check out that one. So again I was giving the 4 inch, so press enter. This is my first chamfer line and this is my second chamfer line. See, this has been trimmed off. If you want to check out the dimension for this one, you can check out the dimension for this one, 4 inch, right? So after doing this first edge to be chamfered, but this fillet, this chamfer came out of its command. So it should be stay in the command. Means what I need to do, I need to follow your multiple method, right? Similarly what we have done in case of your fillet, the same thing we need to apply over here also. CHA is my shortcut command key and press enter. So again what I need to do, I need to select your multiple method. So press M and press enter. Now what I need to do, I was going with respect to first method, that is distance. For that what I need to do, I need to give the dimension D, then press enter. Now it is asking you to be give the first chamfer length. I was giving here now 6 inch, and for second chamfer length I was taking as a 6 inch. See here, this is my first chamfer length, first chamfer line, and this is my second chamfer line. So I was clicking was the first chamfer line and this is my second chamfer line. You can check out here, but the command, it has not came out of this chamfer command. So you can continue the work by clicking or by selecting the two opposite lines. See here, I was doing the continuous, but this command is still in the chamfer mode. So if you want to come out of this that command, then you need to press the escape, right? So when you are doing the similar distance for all the four edges, what I need to do, I need to go with a polyline method instead of going the multiple, instead of selecting all the opposite lines. So what I can do, I can go with a polyline method. By a single click I can chamfer for all the four edges. So how we can do that one, that is by giving a command CHA, then press what, polyline P, then press enter. Then you need to select the distance method. Under this distance method you need to give the chamfer length, that is 6 inch and 6 inch. See here, if I was clicking at this particular, then definitely it is going to be convert all the edges into a angle or a inclined line, that is a distance of 6 inch. For example, if I was selecting this one, see here, in this case, in this rectangle, each line is independent to each other, but in this case we got all the lines are connected to each other. This polyline method is valid for this all the points which is connected to each other, not independent to each other, because this is not a 2D polyline rectangle, right? So if you want to check out that one, see here, CHA chamfer I was giving, I was taking a polyline command. Under this polyline I was taking a distance method D. Then what I need to do, I need to give the two dimensions, that is your first chamfer length and second chamfer length I have been given over here, right? 6 and 6, right? See here what I was doing, if I was taking this one as my first chamfer length, so it is not going to be select, because these lines, each lines are independent to each other. Instead of this rectangle, if I was going here, this to be done in the polyline method, because they are connected to each other. Because of that reason, here what we are getting, we are getting chamfered, this rectangle, not this one, because it is not a 2D polyline, right? So this is about your second method, a second process, that is your polyline method. So if you want the third one, third, now we'll go with respect to the trim or no trim method. So under this also you can check out here, right? I have been taken the two different rectangles to be done, one with respect to your trim method and one with respect to no trim method. So here again we got the chamfer command CHA we need to give. So under this, what I need to do, I need to select the trim mode. So when you are selecting trim mode, we got the two different methods, one is your trim method or one more is your no trim. So I will select the trim mode. So under this again we are going to get the two different methods, one is your angle and distance. I was going with respect to distance, so I will give D, and I will give the chamfer distance, how much I will give for each case, 3 inch 3 inch, right? This is my first chamfer line and this was my second chamfer line. See here, this edge has been trimmed off because I have been selected here trim mode, so because of that reason it has been trimmed off, right? So if you want to, if you don't want to trim this edge, if you don't want to trim this edge, if you want to keep in the same format, and again you require this chamfer length also, what you need to do, you need to go for the chamfer command, that is CHA, press enter. Again, what you need to do, you need to select the trim mode T, or you can directly click on the trim. So after here, what you need to do, you need to select the no trim mode. Already it is in trim mode, now you need to select the no trim mode. Again, I was going with respect to distance method. So under this distance method, what I need to do, I will give the 4 inch for each of the cases, means first chamfer length and second chamfer length, I was giving 4 4. This was my first chamfer length and this was my second chamfer length. See here, first this one, second this one, but this edge has not been trimmed off because we have selected the no trim. So no trim method, if you have selected, then definitely it is not going to be trim your edge part. So this is about your distance method. Now we'll go with respect to angle method. So in this angle method, same chamfer we are going to do. I am going to select four different triangles, rectangles. See here, first what you need to do, you need to give the same chamfer command CHA. And after this, what you need to do, you need to select A, because now we are moving with respect to angle. So press A, enter. Now it is asking you specify chamfer length on the first line. For example, if you are considering this is your first line, from this line at what distance to be chamfered, right? So again I was giving the 4 inch. Now it is asking you, you need to specify the angle. See here, I was giving the specify the chamfer angle from first line, from this line at what angle to be chamfered with respect to the second line. So I was giving how much, 30 degree. So press enter. So this I have been considered as my first length and this was my second length, right? So you need to check out. So already the extended line is there, this because there is no trim mode is already switched on, because of that reason this edge has not been trimmed off. Now you need to check out what is the distance, what is the angle between these two lines, right? So for this you got shortcut command DAL. See, sorry, DAN, you need to press this and this, right? See, you got 30 degree, right? So the similar case you can go with respect to multiple, for each, what you call each line or each edge you want to convert into a chamfer, if you want to change into a chamfer, what you need to do, you need to go with respect to multiple method, polyline method, trim or no trim method. So I will go one by one, CHA, then press what, I was going with a multiple multiple mode. So multiple I have been given. Again I will go with respect to angle. Now I will give the first chamfer length, that is 4 inch, and I was giving the 45 degree angle. Now see here, this was my first and this was my second chamfer line. So if you are checking these two lines, it is 45 degree now, right? If you want to check this distance, I have been given whatever the distance I have been given, so that distance it is going to be indicated over here, right? So similarly, the command is not out of the chamfer command, because I have been selected a multiple method or multiple method, because of that reason it is not going to be out of my command, right? So because this edge is not trimming up, because the trim mode is switched on. Now we'll go with respect to polyline. See here, CHA, I was giving the command. So under this CHA command, I will select now polyline, right? This polyline I was selecting. So after that, what I need to do, I was going with respect to the angle mode, right? Press angle A. Now it is asking you the first chamfer line. This was my first chamfer line. At what distance I need to be chamfer? So I was considering 6 inch. Now press enter. Now the asking angle, so I will give 60 degree, right? So once I click here, see here, from this line to this, if you are checking the angle, right, you are going to get how much? You are going to get the 60 DAN. See here, 60 degree, right? Similarly, if you want you can check out all the angles. You can check out all the angles, whatever the angles we have been provided over there, you can check out all the angles, right? It is with respect to your what will call polyline method. So similarly, if you want to go with a trim or no trim mode, so you need to give the chamfer command CHA, press enter, again you go for a trim mode. So under this, already it is no trim, so I will select a trim mode. So under this trim mode, I will go with respect to angle mode. So again, it is going to ask you the first chamfer length. If I was considering this was my first line, so from this point, how much distance to be chamfered? So I was taking again 6 as an example, I was taking inch, and I was giving 30 degree angle. So this to this, right? So I will check to check your what you call this, what is the angle from here to here. What you need to do, you need to check these two lines, right? 30 degree I have been given, see here, 30 degree I have been given, this is 30 degree. And if you want to check your dimension length also, you can go ahead, right? 6 inch I have been given. If you, it is not clearly visible, now you can check out here this 6 inch length. So this is about your chamfer. If you got any queries regarding chamfer, you can comment in the comment section. So definitely I will give the clarity about this chamfer. So if you have any queries regarding this, you can go through this. Thank you guys.